Hey, what's up guys, it's Renaldo here. So today I've brought you to the Buddy Rasmus Stadium in Nelson Mandela Bay. And the simple reason for that is because this is a shining example of ANC failure in this metro. Now there are thousands of places like this across South Africa. And the reason I brought you here is because Nelson Mandela Bay is a strategic opportunity for opposition parties to win a metro outside of the Western Cape. So the reason I brought you here is to show what the ANC has done and why they are in trouble in Nelson Mandela Bay. But instead of me continuously talking about it, let me show you. So just to sum it up very quickly for you, Nelson Mandela Bay Stadium cost hundreds of millions of rand. At the moment it's being underutilized, and obviously the taxpayers has to fork out the money to make that stadium survive. Here we've got the Buddy Rasmus Stadium that's literally 200 meters away from the ocean. It's prime real estate, and the ANC over the last decade has done nothing to change this in order to make this a hotspot for Nelson Mandela Bay and also to uplift tourism. At the moment, the way that you see it as it is right now, it's actually a place for vagrants to live, and there's been an increase in crime in this area. So once again, the ANC fails to deliver. Alright, so with all that negative stuff being said, I'm on my way now to Gouws FM, which is the biggest radio station in the Eastern Cape. I'm going to go and visit my friend Wayne Hart, and then I'll show you a little bit of the studio and just something to end this video in a positive manner. So I hope you enjoy. Alright, so we're at the boardwalk where Gouws FM is situated. The other thing also of Port Elizabeth is the fact that like PE gets like four seasons in one day. So earlier when I was recording the footage at the Buddy Rasmus Stadium, it was like freezing and the wind was howling. And now it feels like it's like 29 degrees. It's typical PE weather, of course. So just as I arrive here, you can see they've got the fountain display going on in the background. How are you? I'm good, man. What's news?
I never shake hands like that.
I know, it's weird, it's a blog thing.
I actually just cleaned the studio for you.
Oh, did you?
Look, it's sparkling clean, we've got some proper natural light coming through, we've got some romantic music playing. Do you like it?
Is that for me?
It's for you.
Alright guys, I'm here at Gouws FM with one of my mates, Wayne Hart. Say hello, Wayne.
Hey, Renaldo.
So we can just still chill here for about 15 minutes and just talk to Wayne about Gouws FM and random things about South Africa. Okay, so firstly, what show do you do on Gouws FM?
It's The Drive with Wayne Hart. I've been presenting this show in its current format now for about almost 6 months now, but I've been doing this show for this year. It will be my sixth year doing the afternoon drive. And this year actually marks my 10 years at Gouws FM.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you. If I make it to September, if they still renew my contract, it'll be 10 years.
I think 10 years in radio is long enough. I think you're going to get like a secret.
Stop. Stop. I like my job. This is such a pity that the song is playing in the background while we're chatting so nicely. Did you even pick it up?
Yes, in my name.
Yeah! It's Gouws FM with Leonie May and you, Sumini Mirni.
Alright, so what do you love most about South Africa?
You know what I realized this weekend is when I got into my car and I drove down to the Garden Route, which is about a 3-hour drive from Port Elizabeth. Knysna, you know Knysna, you've been there. That's what I loved about it, South Africa, is that you can get in your car and you can go to the most beautiful place in the world with very little effort, getting in your car, put some petrol in and have a weekend away and then come back here. That's what I love about South Africa.
So basically
it's the beauty of our country.
Basically going to the Western Cape.
You had to do that, didn't you? Yeah.
Yeah, it's true.
Yeah. It's a beautiful part of the world. It really is.
Welcome back. You're tuning into 5FM. Oh, wait.
Hey!
Channel. Sorry. That's why I don't do radio. All right. So obviously, asking you what you love most about South Africa, I also have to ask, what do you dislike, or hate is a strong word, but what do you really dislike about South Africa at the moment?
I don't like hate. Hate's a bad word.
I like hate.
I think, but yeah, I dislike where we're going in terms of crime. It's always been a problem in South Africa, but I was affected by crime twice this year in a matter of 2 weeks, where I had my house burgled. And I've only been living there for a year. So it was broken into, stole a fair amount of my personal belongings, and 2 weeks after that, and you're still recovering, they broke in again and took the remainder of the stuff that they left. So I'm disliking the crime, the fact that we have to live with fences around us, and I have to invest money in security and electric fencing. It's just, for me, it's unnecessary. We shouldn't be living like that. And I'm just, as a citizen, I'm just concerned about where we are at the moment in the state of this country.
And the obvious question is, have they been caught?
As far as I know, no.
See, that's also another problem. That is one of the biggest issues we have, I know, in South Africa, mm-hmm. is the fact that we've got so many criminals and so little police officers.
Well, put it this way, the first people that were on the scene were actually the people that I have to pay extra per month to look after my premises. I'm talking about a security company who provide my alarm systems. And the police officers were only at my house an hour and a half after it happened. I've never received a follow-up call, or if there were arrests made, I don't know.
So what do you like most about your job?
What don't I like about my job? You know what, being in radio is like, it gets into your blood, and once it's there, it stays there. It doesn't go anywhere. I've been doing this for 16 years now, and if you had to take this away, I think it would be like taking a part of my life away, because I've been doing this for such a long time. I don't care about the attention, the fame, the pictures, the recognizing me. I do this because it's my job, and it's a passion, and I love it. And I've always loved it for as long as I can remember, since I was a child.
So is that old saying, if you make your passion your job, you won't work a day in your life? Is that true for you?
I do work. We work damn hard, yeah.
Yeah, but is it your passion?
It is my passion, yes.
So then you don't work a day in your life?
I do work.
You don't have to sell.
I work. This is a job. It just so happens that I have a really cool job that I enjoy doing.
All right, so the last question for the day. I know you're a busy man. Thank you so much for your time. With all of that being said, the last question is, are you optimistic for the future of South Africa?
Absolutely. I wouldn't be here if I wasn't optimistic. What I'm liking at the moment is that I'm seeing that there are more people that want the country to be successful at the moment, and so they will fight to make sure that the country goes in the right direction. So there's plenty of hope. I'm very optimistic about
it. I agree with you. There's a lot more people that want the country to succeed, and you've got your left-wing and your right-wing fringe groups that basically want us to burn. But I do feel that the majority of South Africans just want to live their lives, want a peaceful environment, and want a successful country.
And jobs.
And jobs, my friend. So on that note, we're going to end it. Thank you so much. Really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Wayne, it's been a pleasure. Bye. I really appreciate it. Bye. See you soon. Ciao, ciao. All right, I just ended the interview with Wayne and I'll Go FM. And this is basically where I'm going to end the video. So thank you so much for watching. And I'll see you guys tomorrow. Till later. Cheers and peace out. Ah.